Hi, friends. Welcome, welcome, welcome to an offshoot of our asynchronous Quinn and Street Project lesson plans. We are the Quinn and Street Project. My name is Miss Madison. I use she, her pronouns. Over here somewhere, we have Mr. Bryan.
Mr. Bryan, and I use he, him pronouns.
And we also have Miss Anna.
Hi, I'm Miss Anna, and I use she, her pronouns.
Awesome. And friends, this chunk of lessons is going to be focused on movement. All right. So we know, or if this is your first Quinn and Street Project class, maybe you don't know that drama is storytelling using our tools of an actor. And we have three tools of an actor. They are body, voice, and imagination. And so this chunk is going to be focused on, you guessed it, the body. But we're also going to be using a lot of our imagination, and sometimes we'll use our voice too, because they all connect. But we want to really take some time to focus on our body and movement. So today we're going to be talking about why movement is so important to storytelling and why we focus so much on it in drama. And then each week after that, we're going to be exploring a different type of movement and a different type of kind of movement acting technique. And it's going to be really, really a lot of fun. So hope you'll join us. The first thing we need to do is we need to check in about how we're feeling because we're here in class. We're going to say one word. We already introduced ourselves. So we're going to say one word about how we're feeling. And because we're studying movement, let's add a gesture as well. So a gesture is just something you do with your body. I'm feeling wiggly. And I'm going to pass it to Miss Anna.
I'm feeling excited.
Yeah. Awesome. Mr. Bryan.
I'm feeling bouncy.
Ooh. I like the gestures. That's fun. Friends, how are you feeling? Awesome. Cool. Loved those gestures. Loved all that energy. Very nice. Let's take a big, deep, grounding breath in and a big, deep breath out. That felt really good. Let's do one more. Deep breath in. Fill your body and deep breath out, grounding down. Awesome. We are going to warm up now. For today, you can stay seated. Any week, you can stay seated or stand up. It's totally up to you. I'm going to sit down for today just because my body's feeling a little bit tired and we got to listen to that, you know? So here we go. Reach up to the sky. Stretch, 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 stretch. We're going to take it over to the left. Reach, reach, reach. And we're going to take it over to the right. Reach, 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 reach. This is a mirror. Don't worry. No one is in my house. All right. Deep breath in. And a big fake yawn to relax us. Awesome. Let's take our heads. We're going to drop our left ear to the left shoulder. We're going to drop our chin to our chest. We're going to drop our right ear to the right shoulder. And we're going to come all the way up. Now smooth that out into some nice circles. Smoothing it out. You can imagine that you have a crayon or a marker or something, maybe paint, on the top of your head and you're drawing huge circles on the ceiling. And we're going to go the other direction. So we're going to drop our right ear to our right shoulder, our chin to our chest, our left ear to our left shoulder, and back up. And some nice, smooth, big circles. I'm envisioning that I'm painting in blue paint, and that's what's going on the ceiling. So you can, you know, have an image if you want it. Very nice. And you're going to bring your head back up to center, stack it nice and high over your heart. There you go. And we're going to roll our shoulders back. Roll our shoulders back. Maybe now we're painting circles on the wall. On the wall. And roll your shoulders forward. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now you're gonna stretch, stretch, stretch your chest forward as far as you can, and you're gonna come into a superhero position and say, ha ha!
Ha ha!
Nice. And then you are going to bring it back in. Pull your shoulders down into an evil supervillain, and you are going to say, ha ha! Very good. And stretch, superhero, ha ha!
Ha ha!
Ha ha!
And bring it in, evil villain. Very nice. And as fast as you can go, ready, go. Superhero. Oh my goodness. That was tiring. I need a big fake yawn from you. Deep breath in. And a big fake yawn. Awesome. Wonderful. All right. If you are standing up or if you are sitting down, if you're standing up, shake your legs out. If you're sitting down, get your legs out in front of you and give them a good shake. Shake, 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 shake. Maybe you can hear my feet. Thunderstorm, thunderstorm, thunderstorm. Awesome. Pat your legs. Give me a rainstorm. Nice. Pat your chest. And waking up that body, pat your shoulders. And then, oh, the rain's getting a little bit smaller. We're going to just do tap, tap, tap. One more time, a little bit faster. Start with your feet and your legs. Thunder. Ah! Thunder, 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 and rain! Rain, 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 and light, 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 drizzle, drizzle, drizzle. Very nice. All right, deep breath in, deep breath out. Ooh, and I think we are ready. Do you guys feel warm?
I do.
Awesome, wonderful. So, friends, we are going to play. No, we're not. I'm going to talk for a second. And then we're going to play a game. All right, so here we go. Why is movement so important to drama? Let's talk about it. The first thing that comes to mind is sometimes we need to communicate not using words, right? If we speak a different language than somebody that we're performing for, or if they speak a different language than us, if maybe we're doing a play with no words, maybe it just has music in it, yeah? We just have to use our bodies to tell the story. And those can be really powerful forms of communication. Yeah, waving, that's nonverbal communication. What are some other examples of nonverbal communication, Mr. Bryan or Miss Anna?
Oh, I thought you were gonna say something, Anna. I was just gonna say something like a thumbs up. Like for a
yeah, college. Thumbs up.
Sometimes grown-ups have to drive in places where the guards have to give us a stop or a go.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Or friends, when you need help crossing the street, right? People wave you on, people wave you away. Maybe sometimes, yeah, maybe sometimes somebody's on the phone, they go, or maybe sometimes you're on Zoom and your grown-up starts to walk through the door and they're going to be on your camera. So you go, yeah, that's all nonverbal communication. All right. So movement can be super, super important to our storytelling. Another thing that we can use our bodies for is creating characters, right? Tell me what kind of character you think this is. What kind of character do you think that is?
Someone mean.
Someone mean? Did I say something mean? No. How did you know that I was, how did she know that I was mean, Mr. Bryan?
Oh, the way that you were positioned, you were real small and your face scrunched up and yeah.
Yeah, let's try another one. What kind of character is this?
That looks like a happy character.
Yeah, did I say I was happy? No, right, friends? So we can communicate what types of characters we are based on our movement. And the other things that our bodies are really good for, we just did it when we warmed up, are creating energy, yeah? If we just sat here totally still and spoke with our voices like this all the time, even if we wanted to do fun things with our voices and we tried to do our voices like this, yeah, I just don't feel it, right? I don't feel energetic. I don't feel in character. I don't feel like I'm acting. So our bodies are super, super important. They're the first thing that is going to move. And then that can affect our voice and our imagination too. All right. Does that kind of make sense? We get why movement's so important? Yeah. Awesome. All right. So friends, now we get to play a dance. All right, but we get to play a game. We do get to dance. I spoiled it. Okay. So friends, we are going to play freeze dance, but it's a little bit different. All right. It's a little bit different. I'm not going to tell you how it's different yet, because it's a little bit of a mystery. All right, so I'm gonna share some sound. I'm gonna get some tunes bumping. All right. I did have music ready, and now I didn't. Alrighty, here we go, here we go. It's happening, it's happening. Everybody move your body, stay warm, stay warm. Nice, stay warm, stay warm. Yes, yes, Yes. Awesome. Okay, friends. Now we are going to... All right, so we are going to dance. And when I stop the music, we're going to freeze. All right, that's step one. Try to freeze in a really big pose, yeah? So don't be like, oh, I got to freeze and do nothing, okay? Try to freeze in a really fun, big, exciting pose. Here we go. All right, and now, Mr. Bryan, I'm gonna put you on the spot. You are going to justify your movement. So what you're gonna say is who you are and what you're feeling.
Who I am and what I'm feeling.
Mm-hmm.
I am a fire dancer and I'm feeling hot.
Nice, all right, here we go. Let's do a different song to mix it up. Are you and what are you feeling?
I work in a zoo and I'm approaching a crocodile from behind to give it a vaccine.
And how does that make you feel?
Nervous and justified.
Awesome, very nice. All right, let's do another one.
Bit I've been forgotten, I joke. I've been married long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cotton Eye Joe. Bit I've been forgotten, I joke. I've been married long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cotton Eye Joe. Bit I've been forgotten, I joke. I've been married long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cotton Eye Joe.
And peace. All right, I'm gonna go. I am a runner and I just want to race. And I'm feeling punk, so I'm throwing my fist up in the air. Woohoo! All right. Very nice, friends. So, friends, you can do that over and over. Actually, let's do one more, and we're going to open it up for our friends to come up with theirs. Here we go.
It's peanut butter jelly time. Peanut butter jelly time.
Peanut butter jelly time.
Way at, way at, way at, way at. Now there you go.
There you go.
There you go.
There you go. Peanut butter jelly.
All right, friends, you freeze. Friends out there watching, who are you? What are you feeling? What are you doing? Interesting. A snake with a secret? Oh, boy. I don't know if that's what you said, friends, but if it was, what an incredible guess. All right. So
please tell us if that's what you were doing.
Please tell us. All righty, friends. That got Miss Madison a little overly excited. So let's take a big, deep, grounding breath. Here we go. Deep breath in. And deep breath out. Awesome. Now we're going into our serious actorness. Just kidding. It's still going to be fun. But we'll take it really seriously. Okay, here we go. So friends, the next thing we are going to do. So what actually, stop, Miss Madison. What did that tell us about how we can create characters using just our bodies? What did that tell us? Mr. Bryan, Miss Anna, what did we learn?
That you can do a lot with energy and how open or closed you are.
Very good, yeah, really good.
I was gonna say that sometimes your body, I'm gonna try that sentence again. sometimes just moving your body will help your brain think of things. Even if you don't have time to plan ahead, you can't overthink it if you're just dancing and moving your body.
Yeah, I love that. All right, awesome. Good job, friends. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to see how our bodies can affect the way that we say lines when we're acting, the way that we say lines, okay? So I'm gonna pull up our whiteboard here. And Mr. Bryan and Miss Anna, let's just get some verbs. Let's just get some acting verbs. Friends, acting verbs are things that we wanna be doing actively towards someone. So we're gonna complete the sentence. I want to blank you, all right? So what are some verbs that could, I'm gonna do a new text box. What are some verbs that could complete this sentence?
Chase.
Just shout them out. What?
Chase.
Chase.
Interrupt.
Interrupt. Race.
Hug.
I said hug already. Bully.
Oh.
Love.
Shove.
Shove. We're doing rhyming today.
Elbow.
Elbow.
Kick.
Ooh. All right, let's get a couple more non-violent.
Pet.
Pet. And one more, Mr. Bryan, non-violent.
Compliment.
Oh, that's lovely. All right, friends, so now what we're going to do is each of us is going to pick one of these words, all right? And we're going to say it totally neutral first, all right? So let's say, I'll do an example. Let's say I'm gonna do chase, all right? So I want to chase you. Fine, if you say so, but I didn't really believe it, did you? No, okay? So I want to chase you. Let's add a gesture. So what do I think the word chase is? I want to chase you. Yeah? Did we believe it more that time? Did I say different words? No, what changed?
Your movement.
My movement, yeah? What happened to my voice when I did a movement that corresponded to what I was saying?
Your movement changed your voice even if you weren't thinking about it.
Yeah, totally. All right. Mr. Bryan, let's have you do one. Pick a word, say it once neutral, and then once with some energy, with movement.
Okay. I'll go with shove. I want to shove you.
I didn't believe it.
Oh, no. I want to shove you.
Ah, I believed it. Ah. And now I'm scared. All right, Miss Anna, do you want to try one?
I want to compliment you. I'm gonna try it again, really, really neutral. I want to compliment you.
No, you don't.
No, I don't. All right, here we go. Now, this one's kind of abstract. Okay, here we go. I want to compliment you.
Oh, I felt it. And I really felt like Miss Anna was about to give me a compliment. Awesome, friends. Now you try. Oh, the snake with the secret wants to bully you. Oh, no. Alrighty, friends. Good job. So both of these activities showed us that acting is more than just saying words, right? It's using our bodies to tell stories. That movement is going to be really, really important. So over the course of these lessons, we're going to explore different ways because, friends, it turns out that not every movement technique is going to work for every single actor, right? That's why there's so many techniques. My favorite thing about acting is that it's like, and learning how to act, is that it's like a sushi platter, all right? Vegan sushi, vegetable sushi, fish sushi, whatever kind of sushi you want, all right? Everything on the sushi platter is edible. You can eat it, yeah? But you're not gonna know what you like until you try every piece. But once you take a piece, say you fully tried it and you don't like it, you never have to eat that sushi ever again. And that's just like acting techniques, right? I'm gonna show you all of these different movement techniques. And once you try it once and you're like, that's not for me, Miss Madison, you don't have to do it again, but you have to try it in order to you have to try it in order to figure out if you like it, all right? Or if you'll go, okay. So friends, here we go. Let's take one more deep breath. I'm so excited to go on this movement journey with you all. Let's breathe in, breathe out. Awesome. Let's do a quick check out about how we're feeling now. I'm feeling wild. Mr. Bryan, how are you feeling? Let's add a gesture. Sorry. I'm sorry, Mr. Bryan. I want to interrupt you. All right. Alrighty, friends. So I'm sorry, Mr. Bryan. I'm feeling wild. All right, Mr. Bryan, now it's your turn. Add a gesture.
I'm feeling dazzled. Go with that.
I assume I'm next because I'm.
You are.
Okay. I'm feeling happy.
Awesome. All right, friends, let's do one more of those big fake yawns. Let's deep breath in.
Big fake yawn.
Ooh, awesome. Everybody put your hands in the middle. And we're going to say drama class on three. Ready? One, two, three.
Drama class.
Awesome. Thanks, friends. See you next week.
Yay. Thank you.